Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you in English language the April 1st week part 2. Now, before this, I uploaded April 1st week part 1, so do check that out also. And you might notice that I have written some questions in Hindi also on the screen, but that does not mean that the English ones are not written. This is just to facilitate those people who are from Hindi background, and the questions will be written in both Hindi and English, so let not yourself get distracted and focus on only the English font. So let's start the video. I have covered 120 questions. One very important announcement, our sale has started from today, that is 11th of April. It will continue till 18th of April. This is the sale. If you want to buy our some of the best selling courses for SSC, Bank, PO, UPSC, then just go to this website studyiq.com. The PDF also you will get on the website in the download section. Now, I was not uploading the videos because I was very busy with environment, ecology, current affairs for our UPSC pen drive students. And for 11 days straight, I have been recording like 10 hours a day. So now I'm free, and now you will see a lot of videos on our YouTube channel for our free language, free, users also, not just the premium ones. So you can follow me on Instagram. I have started posting quiz also on Instagram. My ID is Tireless Soul. You can follow me on Twitter. My ID is GauravGar888. So what is the name of the virtual assistant that was launched by Small Industries Development Bank of India on its foundation day? It is called Samriddhi. Small Industries Development Bank of India. Its chairman is Mohammed Mustafa. Now you will see my writing improve because I have taken a new pad, Mohammed Mustafa, and it is headquartered in Lucknow. Right? Don't confuse it with SEBI. SEBI is headquartered in Mumbai. I'm talking about SIDBI. SIDBI is the same organization that runs the Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana. Minister of State for Power, R.K. Singh, he is also the Minister for New and Renewable Energy. He laid down the foundation stone of the 60 megawatt Naithwar Mori hydroelectric project at which place? This was set up in Uttarakhand. Uttarakhand. And remember that there is a Lansdowne Tiger Division which connects Rajaji Tiger Reserve and Jim Corbett Tiger Reserve in Uttarakhand. This is very important because it meets the global criteria, international standard criteria for the tiger reserves. Only 13% of the tiger reserves in the world, they have met the international criteria. Uttarakhand has the second highest number of tigers in India after Karnataka, and Uttarakhand CM is Trivendra Singh Rawat. And also remember, India recently inaugurated the largest single place solar power plant in Karnataka, in Tumkur village, in Pavagada village in Tumkur district, which is called Shakti Sthal. Shakti Sthal, and it is 2000 megawatt is the capacity for the same. What is the name of the new organ that has been discovered by the scientists recently? It is called interstitium. It was discovered in connective tissue all over the body. It is made up of strong collagen and flexible elastin connective tissue proteins. So collagen is the strong protein and elastin is relatively weaker and flexible. Grammer Cramer has been removed as the captain of which cricket team? Because this team could not qualify for the World Cup that will take place next year. So this team is Zimbabwe, and Harare is the capital of Zimbabwe. Now remember that the coach of this team was Heath Streak, and he was removed as the coach. And the new captain of Zimbabwe cricket team would now be Brendan Taylor. Which football team has won the Santosh Trophy title at the Salt Lake Stadium in Kolkata? It is Kerala, and it was their sixth title. They defeated Bengal. They defeated Bengal, and Kerala CM is Pinarayi Vijayan. And there is a Mathikettan Shola National Park in Kerala in Idukki district, which was in news because it is only 5 kilometers away from Tamil Nadu's India Neutrino Observatory project, which is coming up in Theni. So remember Mathikettan Shola. There is also Pambadam Shola and Periyar National Park also. Now Periyar is famous for elephants also, and types of tiger reserve also. And Kerala has the third highest number of elephants in India after Karnataka and Assam. And Kerala state animal is also elephant. And it has two important dance. One is called Kathakali, one is called Mohini Attam. Who has been selected for the J.C. Daniel Award by the government of Kerala? His name is Mr. Shri Kumaran Thampi, and it is Kerala government's highest honor for lifetime contribution to Malayali cinema. So Thambi is a very renowned lyricist, scriptwriter, and producer also. Largest nation building digital initiative of the Ministry of Human Resource Development, it concluded recently. The 36-hour long exercise was named what? More than 8,000 students participated. It was called Smart India Hackathon. Smart India Hackathon. The Ministry of Finance it has announced that a record number of digital transactions were processed through the public financial management system called PFMS on 28th of March. These transactions were worth how much amount? There were more than 98 lakh transactions, 9.8 million, amounting to 71,633 crore rupees. Now remember that public finance management system, it is implemented by the Controller General of Accounts and administered by the Department of Expenditure. Niti Aayog, and the gentleman here is Amitabh Kant. He is the CEO of Niti Aayog and Vice Chairman is Rajiv Kumar. So National Institution for Transforming India, they made a list of 115 aspirational districts, which are essentially the districts in India which are affected by Naxalism or terrorism. And we want to do welfare in these 115 aspirational districts. Now remember, three states in India have decided not to be a part of this. One is West Bengal, one is Odisha, and one is Kerala. West Bengal, Odisha, and Kerala will not be a part of the aspirational district scheme by the central government. So they will do the ranking of these 115 based on 49 parameters. And these are based on five sectors. Health, 49 parameters are in five sectors: health, education, then nutrition, agriculture, and water resources. SWIFT has announced to extend its GPI tracker to cover all the payment instructions set across the network. S in SWIFT stands for what? SWIFT basically stands for Society for Worldwide Interbank Telecommunication. I repeat, Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. So S stands for Society. And the headquarter of SWIFT is in La Halpe. La Halpe is in Belgium. Capital of Belgium is Brussels, and Brussels is the headquarter of NATO, North Atlantic Treaty Organization. Who has been appointed as the new chairman and managing director of the Rashtriya Ispat Nigam Limited? Ispat means steel. His name is P.K. Rath, and the headquarter of this is in headquarter of this company is in Vishakhapatnam, which is called Vizag. It is the third cleanest city of India, and its railway station is the cleanest in India in the A1 category. Vishakhapatnam is in Andhra Pradesh. Now, Andhra Pradesh was in news because of various reasons. Andhra Pradesh has Papikonda National Park, important. And it also has Nagarjun Sagar Sri Salam Tiger Reserve. Nagarjun Sagar Sri Salam Tiger Reserve. From this, when the Telangana got separated, then a part of Nagarjun Sri Salam came in Telangana, which was then renamed Amrabad Tiger Reserve. So Amrabad Tiger Reserve is in Telangana. Nagarjun Sri Salam Tiger Reserve is in Andhra Pradesh. It also has a Pulikat Lake. Pulikat Lake also. And Koringa Elephant Reserve also. These are all important in Andhra Pradesh. What is the name of Asia's largest startup conclave that was organized by the government of Kerala? Kerala Startup Mission in Kovalam in Kerala. What is the name? The name is called Huddle Kerala. Huddle Kerala. And he is Pinaray Vijayan, the CM of Kerala. He is party CPIM. And Satashivam, Justice P. Satashivam is the governor of Kerala. Central government has filed a review petition against the Supreme Court's order ending the immediate arrest in complaints filed under what? So basically, under ST Act, if you are arrested, you will not be, you cannot apply for bail, you know, immediate bail. So you can't apply for anticipatory bail. And this is as per the provisions of SC ST Act of 1989. Now, what is the problem with this? Problem is that the Supreme Court, they have allowed bail now. So this leads to dilution of the act. And our tribal affair minister is Jual Oram. Jual Oram is the is a Lok Sabha MP from Sundargarh in Odisha, who has been elected as the Prime Minister of Ethiopia. His name is Abiy Ahmed. Capital of Ethiopia is Addis Ababa. It's an African country. And remember that Ethiopia, there is another gentleman who is very famous from Ethiopia, Tedros Adhanom. And Tedros Adhanom is the Director General of World Health Organization. The Ministry of Finance, they have announced to release a commemorative coin marking the 350th birth anniversary of Shri Guru Gobind Singh Ji. He was the 10th Sikh Guru. So you have to tell me what is the denomination of the coin. It is 350 rupee coin. 350 rupee coin. Who has been appointed as the state election icon for Karnataka Assembly polls? Karnataka Assembly polls will be conducted in only one phase, and they will be conducted on 12th of May. So mark this date if you are from Karnataka, and he is Rahul Dravid. Now CM is Siddaramaiah. See, Mr. Siddaramaiah, Karnataka state animal is elephant. It has the highest number of tigers and elephants in India as per the Tiger Survey and Elephant Survey respectively. And it has important national parks like Anshi National Park, Banargatta, Bandipora National Park, Dandeli Tiger Reserve, Kudremukha Reserve, and so on. Capital is Bengaluru. Whose tenure has been extended as the chairman and managing director of NBCC? NBCC stands for National Building Construction Corporation. And Mr. Anup Kumar Mittal was due for retiring, but he has been given 1 year extension by the Appointments Committee of the Cabinet. Haryana State Education Department, they have renamed the secondary senior girls school as Shaheed Major Vikas Yadav Senior Secondary School. It is located in which district? This school is located in Kosli. Kosli is in Rewadi. And remember that this is to pay respect to Major Vikas Yadav of the Jat Regiment, who had let down his life fighting terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir. Haryana recently, a World Design University was inaugurated in Sonipat. And also remember, Haryana also inaugurated a butterfly park in Gurugram. And Gurugram is the headquarter of International Solar Alliance also. International Solar Alliance headquarters is in Gurugram. Their first meeting took place in New Delhi. And their target is to have 1000 gigawatt of solar energy by 2030. Now, another thing about Haryana. Recently, there is a village also which is called Donald Trump Village, Maroda Village in Haryana. Maroda Village in Haryana is named after Donald Trump. And the Animal Welfare Board of India, they have shifted their headquarter from Chennai to Ballamgarh in Haryana. This is also handy information. As per Indian Cellular Association, India has overtaken which country to become the second largest producer of mobile phones in 2017? So number one is China and number two was Vietnam, but now India has overtaken Vietnam. So the answer is Vietnam. Capital of Vietnam is Hanoi. India is the second largest mobile producer now. India produced 11 million mobile phones, that is 1.1 crore in 2017. Which country has successfully tested a nuclear capable intercontinental ballistic missile which is called Sarmat? Sarmat has been test fired by Russia. Russia's capital is Moscow and Vladimir Putin has become president for 6 years. America president is elected for 4 years, Russia for 6 years and India China for 5 years. Russia have a rocket also called Soyuz rocket and their space agency is called Roscosmos. Who has been appointed as the director general of the National Testing Agency and which works under the Department of Higher Education in the Ministry of HRD? HRD minister is Prakash Javadekar. So his name is Vinit Joshi and he is the former chairman of CBSC also. These are some of the new positions. Now you don't need to remember all these. There are a lot of joint secretaries and all. Joint secretaries are never asked in the exam. At max they ask secretary like for example Preeti Sudan. She is the secretary in the Ministry of Health and so on. Which country is opposition party? So India was supposed to get Assumption Island for docking their military, right? This was seen as a big victory. But the opposition party of this country has now blocked and India might not get Assumption Island now. This country is Seychelles. Capital is Victoria. Similarly, from Mauritius, we are supposed to get Chagos Island. Chagos Island. From Oman, we are supposed to get Dukam Port. From Sri Lanka, we are supposed to get Trincomalee Port. From Iran, we are supposed to get Shahid Beheshti, which is also called Chabar Port. How many Kirti Chakra awards did President Ramnath Kovind recently confer at the Defense Investiture Ceremony, which was held at Rashtrapati Bhavan? There were 3 Kirti Chakras that were given. And there were 17 Shaurya Chakras. Now remember that India's highest, that is the most prestigious gallantry award during wartime is Paramvir Chakra, during peacetime is Ashok Chakra. Who has taken charge as the Director General of Border Roads, DGBR? His name is Lieutenant General Harpal Singh. Lieutenant General Harpal Singh. Our Income Tax Government, Central Board of Direct Taxes, Income Tax Department, they have extended the deadline for linking your PAN permanent account number to Aadhaar by what? Earlier the deadline was 31st of March, now it is June the 30th, 2018. 17th Sub-Junior National Wushu Championship began where? It began in Jammu. National Highway Authority of India, which is headquartered in New Delhi, it has joined hands with Airport Authority of India for developing a green corridor at which place? This will be set up in Varanasi. It's basically a 16.55 kilometer stretch of National Highway 56 and National Highway 29. Varanasi, by the way, is the Lok Sabha constituency of Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. And Varanasi has signed an agreement with Kyoto. Kyoto is a place in Japan. This is for building smart cities. Who has been appointed as the new president of NASCOM? Her name is Devjani Ghosh. And she has taken over from Mr. R. Chandrasekhar. India and Pakistan, they have agreed to mutually resolve all the issues and dispute regarding the treatment of diplomat. Who is India's High Commissioner to Pakistan? India's High Commissioner to Pakistan is Ajay Bisaria. And also remember, Pakistan's High Commissioner to India is Sohail Mahmood. Sohail Mahmood. And India's Foreign Secretary is Mr. Gokhale. Which sports personality's wax statue is going to be added at Madame Tussauds in New Delhi? Already Kapil Dev, Sachin Tendulkar, Cristiano Ronaldo, their statue is present, and Virat Kohli statue will be added very soon. V. Shri Harsha passed away. V. Shri Harsha was a famous what? So, V. Shri Harsha was a journalist. Which company has launched a new forum which is called Women in Tech? Women in Tech is done by RBS, and this is basically to address the issues of lack of women employees in STEM sector. What is STEM sector? Very, very important. S stands for science, T for technology, E for engineering, and M stands for math. State Bank of India, they have increased the rate on the fixed deposit by 10 to 25 basis points for tenure above how many years? For tenure more than 2 years. So for deposits less than 1 crore in the 5 to 10 year category, the rate will be increased from 6.5 to 6.75%. And for amount less than 1 crore, if it is for 3 to 5 years, then it has been increased from 6.5 to 6.7%. SBI chairman is Rajnish Kumar. Which satellite did China recently launch aboard its Long March 3B rocket for its satellite navigation system? This is Beidou 3. And this was launched from Zhejiang Satellite Launch Center, which is in China's Sichuan province. This is important. Which state government has launched 181? It is a Sakhi toll-free helpline number for women. It has been launched by the government of Assam. Assam, they have a temple in Guwahati which is called Kamakhya Temple. Kamakhya Temple, and Bihu is a dance in Assam. Now remember, a similar sounding scheme is been launched by the government of Goa, which is called Stri Sakhi scheme, and it is basically to provide free or very subsidized sanitary pads to the women and girls. It is called Stri Sakhi scheme. Similar scheme by Kerala is called She Pad scheme. Similar scheme by the government of Odisha is called Khushi scheme, and similar scheme by the government of Maharashtra is called Asmita Yojana. And the Ministry of Chemical Fertilizer, they have recently launched a sanitary napkin called Suvidha, which is only for 2.5 rupees per pad, and it will come in a pack of 4, that is 10 rupees per pack. Who has been appointed chairman of the central panel of the 65th National Film Awards? He is Shekhar Kapoor, the great director. Which small finance bank has opened in India recently started functions? It is called Jan Small Finance Bank. Now, before opening Small Finance Bank, it used to exist as Jan Lakshmi Micro Finance Institution. It is headquartered in Bengaluru, and Ajay Kanwal is the chairman and managing director of this bank. Which bank has announced to deploy mobile point of sales devices across 10,000 banking points in India in a phased manner? This bank is Fino Payment Bank. Fino Payment Bank, and Rishi Gupta is the CEO and headquarters is in Mumbai. It was the fourth payment bank to open in India after Airtel Payment Bank, India Post Payment Bank, and Paytm Payment Bank. An international yachting festival was recently inaugurated where? It was inaugurated in Vishakhapatnam in Vizag in Andhra Pradesh. It was inaugurated by CM Chandra Babu Naidu, who has broken his ties with the BJP, and therefore Ashok Gajapati Raju, who was from Telugu Desam Party, is no more Civil Aviation Minister. Civil Aviation Ministry has been given to Suresh Prabhu. He has been given the additional charge and he is the Minister for Commerce and Industry. Which state assembly in USA, they have designated April of every year as Sikh Awareness and Appreciation Month? Sikh Awareness and Appreciation Month, this has been done by the state New Jersey in America. And remember, Mike Pompeo is the new Foreign Minister, Secretary of State of America. Now you need to tell me who is the new woman CIA director. And she is the first woman to head the Central Investigative Agency CIA in America. Write down her name in comments. What is the 2018 theme of World Autism Awareness Day? So autism is a neurological disorder in which the person, for example, if he is 20 years of age, he will behave like 5 or 6. The mental development is very slow. It was observed on 2nd of April. What was the theme? The theme this time was Empowering Women and Girls with Autism. Which state government has approved a proposal to set up a crime branch under the state police that will deal with unlawful activities and the people who commit felony? This has been done by the government of Tripura. Biplab Kumar Dev is the CM, new CM of Tripura. Capital is Agartala. And the state animal of Tripura is called Faraz Langur. It also has Gumti Wildlife Sanctuary and Rova Wildlife Sanctuary also. And before this, the CM was Manik Sarkar. He was the poorest CM in India. And the richest CM in India is Telugu Desam Party, is Chandrababu Naidu. And the second richest is Pema Khandu. And the oldest CM in India is Captain Amrinder Singh. And the youngest is Pema Khandu. Pema Khandu recently inaugurated Rhododendron Park in Tamang in Arunachal Pradesh. Rhododendron is the national plant of Nepal. Reserve Bank of India has changed the methodology that was used for calculating the bond value. Now, it will be based on what now? And it will be calculated on the last trading day of every quarter. So, this is now weighted average price that will be used. Which indigenously built submarine launch cruise missile was successfully tested by Pakistan? This missile is called Babar. They also have another missile which is called Shaheen Eagle. They have this missile. And Khakan Abbasi is the Prime Minister of Pakistan. Pakistan is also a part of Tapi pipeline. Turkmenistan, Afghanistan, Pakistan and India. So it will go from it. This pipeline will carry gas that will be filled from the Galkinish field in Turkmenistan. Then it will go to Herat and Kandahar in Afghanistan. Then it will go to Quetta and Multan in Pakistan. Then it will reach Fazilka in India in Punjab. This is called Tapi project. And Pakistan Army Chief is Bajwa, Kamar Javed Bajwa. And in Pakistan, Army Chief is said to be the most powerful person. 114th meeting of the Permanent Indus Commission. It recently took place in New Delhi. Who is Indus Water Commissioner of India? Indus Water Treaty, you must have heard about it. 1960, it was signed, mediated by World Bank. So his name is P.K. Saxena. And remember that on the bank of Indus River, we had the Indus Valley Civilization. Recently, there is a place in Haryana called Rakhi Gadi, where a lot of excavations have been done and some very important new developments have come to light regarding Indus Valley. There were also other places like Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, Kalibangan and all that. But Rakhi Gadi is very, very important. Which state's chief minister has announced raising the retirement age of the government employees from 60 to 62? This decision has been taken by the government of Madhya Pradesh. It was the first state in India to have a happiness department. And recently, 5th Nadi Mahotsav or River Festival was celebrated in Madhya Pradesh, inaugurated by Nitin Gadkari, the Minister for Water Resources, River Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. And Madhya Pradesh CM is Sivraj Singh Chauhan, Governor is Anandibhai Patel. It has Narsingad, Orchha Wildlife Sanctuary, Narsingad Wildlife Sanctuary, Ghati Gaon Wildlife Sanctuary, and there are important national parks. And swamp deer is the state animal of Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh both. Logistics company called Rivigo, it has partnered with how many banks recently? There are two banks. One is Yes Bank, headed by Rana Kapoor, and one is IDFC Bank. So the answer is 3 and 4. Which space agency has announced to launch Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment follow-on, which is called GRACE-FO? This is to study Earth's gravity. And they have also recently launched a very highly advanced weather satellite called GOES-S. So it has been done by NASA in association with German agency called DLR. Also, there is a country called Greece. And Greece country, they have launched their own space agency, which is called Hellenic Space Agency. Which country's central bank has allowed its domestic commercial banks to borrow from foreign banks and financial institutions? It is the Nepal Rashtra Bank, Nepal. Nepal's capital is Kathmandu, which is the headquarters of SARC, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. And Nepal has started something known as National Pride Project, which is basically to measure the height of Mount Everest. And Nepal has banned the blind people, the double amputee and the solo people from scaling Mount Everest. Its official height is 8,848 meter. And Nepal's president is Bidya Devi Bhandari, who has been re-elected as the president. And KP Oli, who was on a visit to India, is the prime minister. Which bank has tied up with Indian Medical Association? They have launched a credit card exclusively for doctors. And this will be called Doctors SBI card. So it has been done by State Bank of India. Kotak Mahindra Bank have launched India's first artificial intelligence powered voice bot in the banking sector, what it is called. This bank is headed by Uday Kotak. This is called Kea, K-E-Y-A. Who has won the men's single tennis title in the Miami Open held in Florida, USA? Florida is one of the parts of the Bermuda Triangle. Florida, Puerto Rico and Bermuda. These are the three triangles of Bermuda Triangle. Florida, Bermuda and Puerto Rico. These three. So his name is John Isner. He's an American and he beat Alexander Zverev in the final. Alexander Zverev is a German player. R. K. Dorendra Singh passed away. He was the former chief minister of which state? He was a 4 times chief minister of Manipur. Manipur, you have two important people, Irom Sharmila and Mary Kom. They are from Manipur. Capital is Imphal. Biren Singh is the CM of Bharatiya Janata Party. And recently, Loktak Lake, which is in Manipur, it is the largest lake in the northeast. And Loktak Lake, recently they made a floating laboratory. India's first floating laboratory was made on Brahmaputra River in Assam. And Manipur, that's all you need to know about it. Reserve Bank of India recently celebrated its foundation day on April 1st. It commenced its operations in which year? It was in 1935. Reserve Bank of India was set up on recommendation of Hilton Young Commission. Uttar Pradesh CM Yogi Adityanath, also called Ajay Bisht, his real name, he inaugurated India's longest elevated road called Hindon Elevated Road at which place? So he launched it at Ghaziabad. It will connect Ghaziabad with other places in Uttar Pradesh, and this cost about 11,000 crore rupees. Uttar Pradesh also has Naroda Atomic Power Plant, and they have something known as Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary and Dudhwa National Park. And Dudhwa National Park, recently a birds festival was also organized. Who has been appointed to become the first woman to head UN Political Affairs? What is her name? Her name is Rosemary DiCarlo. UN is headquartered in New York, same place where we have the headquarters of UNICEF. In the last question, recently in Uttar Pradesh, there is a place called Kanpur, and recently Uttar Pradesh's first butterfly park for conservation of butterflies and moth was inaugurated in Kanpur, and Madhya Pradesh's first butterfly park was in Raisen district in Madhya Pradesh, at a place called Gopalpur. And also remember, in Haryana, the first butterfly park was inaugurated in Gurugram. So there are 3 butterfly parks. Haryana's in Gurugram, Raisen district MP, and Kanpur UP. Which airport has been adjudged the cleanest airport in India? It is the Mangaluru Airport in Karnataka. This was announced at the 23rd annual day of the Airport Authority of India, and Civil Aviation Minister is Suresh Prabhu. He has been given the additional charge. Who has been elected as the chairman of the CII Southern Region, Confederation of Indian Industry? His name is Mr. R. Dinesh. He has been appointed for 2018-19. Who are the 2 Indian activists who have been named among the 20 finalists for the Commonwealth Youth Award? So one is Mrinalini Dayal and second is Yogesh Kumar. So the answer is 1 and 4. And who are they? So Mrinalini Dayal is campaign leader for Health Over Stigma campaign. And Kumar is the founder of a social enterprise called Even Cargo. And remember the UN Sustainable Development Goal number 5, which talks about gender equality. And Sustainable Development Goal 2 is for hunger, 1 is for poverty, 3 is for healthcare, and 4 is for education. So these are 5 very important Sustainable Development Goals. Total there are 17. Deadline is 2030. Which sports federation has launched a mobile app called Scout Me to find talent? This mobile app is made by a 17-year-old student, and his name is Kush Pandey. So it is All India Football Federation, headed by Praful Patel. 15th meeting of the India-US Counter-Terrorism Joint Working Group was held where? To have cooperation in the field of anti-terrorism. So it took place in New Delhi. C.V. Rajendran passed away. He was a famous what? He was a film director. He was a film director in the Tamil film industry. Now Tamil Nadu, remember 2-3 very important temples. One is Meenakshi Temple in Madurai. Okay. And this was awarded the best Swachh iconic place in India last year. Okay, best Swachh iconic place. Second temple is the Brihadeshwar temple. Brihadeshwar temple is a Lord Shiva temple in Thanjavur district. It was made by Chola dynasty. Very, very important temple. Always asked in exam. And the third is in Srirangam. It is called Sri Ranganatha Swami temple. It was awarded the UNESCO Asia award for conservation efforts. So these 3 temples are very famous in Tamil Nadu. Now in Tamil Nadu, in Theni, we are building India's neutrino observatory project. India received the first American liquefied natural gas shipment from Cheniere Energy Inc. company at which LNG terminal? This is Dabhol. Where is Dabhol? It is in Maharashtra. We also have Jawaharlal Nehru Port Trust in Maharashtra, which is called Nhava Sheva. And we also have Mumbai Port. So Maharashtra recently, announced a new wildlife sanctuary called Ghodazari. Ghodazari is in Chandrapur in Maharashtra, and they also have one more wildlife sanctuary, very famous, which is called Koyna Wildlife Sanctuary. There is a Koyna Dam also, there is a Koyna River also, and there is another one called Fansad Wildlife Sanctuary. This is over and above the national park like Chandoli National Park, Taloba National Park, and Sanjay Gandhi National Park and so on. 2018-19 budget proposal will come into effect from which date? This date is April 1, the first day of the new financial year. Who has been appointed as Deputy Collector, DC, by Andhra Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu? He is Kidambi Srikant, now the world number one badminton player. World number one, not easy. And his coach is Pulela Gopichand. Who has been appointed by Jammu and Kashmir Cricket Association as the coach for 2018-19 season? His name is Irfan Pathan. Jammu Kashmir has Kishtwar National Park, Dachigam National Park, Hemis National Park, and Kashmiri stag or hangul is the state animal of Jammu Kashmir. It also has Wooler Lake and Dal Lake. Which space agency is going to send its first ever mission called Interior Exploration using seismic investigation, geodesy and heat transport to study deep interiors of Mars? This will be done by NASA, and NASA is also carrying out a Parker mission for studying Sun. They will enter it in the atmosphere of Sun, which is called Corona, and the temperature is close to 2000 degrees C. For that, they have a proper shield, 4.5 centimeter shield over the spacecraft, so that it can tolerate such high temperature. And India wants to study Sun also. Their mission is called Aditya L1. NASA is headquartered in Washington, D.C., the same place where we have the headquarter of IMF and World Bank. Who has been adjudged Sportsman of the Year? Sportsman of the Year by the Telangana Sports Journalist Association. She is Mithali Raj. She is the captain of Indian female cricket team. Now remember that Kidambi Srikant is the also won an award, which was the best senior male player from Telangana, right? And PV Sindhu got the award for the best female senior player. But overall sportsperson of the year is Mithali Raj. Employees Provident Fund Organization, they recently launched a website for which of the following? It is a dedicated portal called epfindia.gov.in/pension payment enquiry. So they launched it for pensioner. And remember that they also, you know, the government recently increased the tax-free gratuity limit from 10 lakh rupees to 20 lakh. In 2017, National Highway Authority of India, they awarded total 150 road projects worth amount 1,22,000 crore. How many kilometer roads will be built? This is 7,400 kilometer. Out of that, highest is 1,234 kilometer in Rajasthan. Which state has won the geographical indication tag for Kadaknath chicken? This chicken is a very famous chicken from the tribal district of Jhabua, which is in Madhya Pradesh. Now, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, they both were claiming that Kadaknath chicken belongs to them. Which city has become the first in India to roll out Euro 6 grade fuel, which is equivalent to Bharat Stage 6 fuel? It is Delhi. It has been started in Delhi because April 2018 was the deadline for Delhi, and for the rest of India, the deadline is April 2020. As per the National Annual Rural Sanitation Survey, what percent of the rural households in India have access to toilets? So 93% have toilet. Also remember, among all the states in India, Madhya Pradesh has the maximum number of tribal households which are covered by drinking water supply. Second is Odisha and third is Jharkhand. So this was announced by our Minister for Sanitation and Drinking Water, Uma Bharti. How much amount of stake is Air India selling? Air India is selling 76% stake. And who is the chairman of Air India? Pradeep Kharola, P.K. Kharola, Pradeep Singh Kharola. India has increased their contribution towards the United Nations Relief and Works Agency called UNRWA for Palestine from $1.5 million to how much? We are giving $3.5 million extra now. So amount we are giving is $5 million to Palestine. East Jerusalem is the capital of Palestine. Which company has acquired the GIF platform, imaging platform called Tenor? It has been acquired by Google recently, and Google CEO is Sundar Pichai. Who has been re-elected as the president of Egypt? His name is Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. Egypt's capital is Cairo. It also has the world famous pyramids, and Egypt also has River Nile. Which union ministry has introduced a Swachh Bharat summer internship for college student? It has been done by the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. And Environment, Forest, Climate Change headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. Housing, Urban Affairs by Hardeep Puri. Rural Development by Narendra Singh Tomar. Who has resigned as the cricket coach of Australia's national team? His name is Daryl Neiman. He has resigned. Who has topped the 2018 IE Indian Express 100 list released by Indian Express? It was number one was Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi. Second was Amit Shah. Third was Chief Justice Deepak Mishra. Deepak Mishra is the 45th Chief Justice of India. Which hot metallic Earth-sized planet has recently been discovered by the scientists orbiting a dwarf star? It has been named K2-229b. It is 260 million light years away from Earth. US military has begun the Foul Eagle and Key Resolve drill with which country? they have started it with South Korea. Recently in South Korea, we had the Pyeongchang Winter Olympics and maximum medals were won by Norway. And in the Paralympics, the maximum medals were won by US. The mascot was Suhurang, which is a white tiger for the Winter Olympic. And there was Asiatic black bear called Bandabi for the Paralympics. So these were the Winter Olympics in South Korea. SEBI has doubled the investment limit by the angel funds in venture capital undertakings to how much? They have doubled it from 5 crore to 10 crore. And the minimum investment is 25 lakh rupees. SEBI also, in the recent meeting, they accepted the several recommendations of the Corporate Governance Committee. What committee it was? It is the Uday Kotak Committee. They gave 80 recommendations and 40 recommendations are accepted by SEBI. SEBI is headquartered by Ajay Tyagi. SEBI is headed by Ajay Tyagi, headquartered at Mumbai. These were the recommendations. Union Cabinet has approved signing a Memorandum of Understanding with United Kingdom and Northern Ireland for cooperation in what? So India will cooperate with United Kingdom and Northern Ireland with for organized crime. Northern Ireland capital is Belfast and Republic of Ireland capital is Dublin. Union Cabinet has approved signing of MOU with which country for IPR, intellectual property rights? We have signed it with Canada. Canada PM is Justin Trudeau. Capital is Ottawa. And in Montreal, we have the headquarter of World Anti-Doping Agency. Ghulam Muhammad Mustafa passed away. He was a what? He was a journalist associated with PIB, Doordarshan, All India Radio and so on. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, they have approved a integrated scheme for school education. Now, which of the old schemes will be subsumed by this? Which means the old scheme will be replaced by this new. Rashtriya Madhyamik Shiksha Abhiyan, Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, Teacher Education, the answer is all of the above. Also remember, there was an Ayushman Bharat scheme called Modi Care, in which we plan to give 5 lakh rupees of health insurance to 10 crore families in India. And Ayushman Bharat has subsumed the Rajiv Gandhi health scheme and also the senior citizen health scheme. Which Formula One driver won the Australian Grand Prix title? This was the first of the new season. So it was won by Sebastian Vettel. He drives Ferrari. And here you can see Lewis Hamilton also on the podium. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has recently removed prohibition on the export of what? So all the prohibitions on the export of edible oil are lifted except mustard oil. We still can't export mustard oil. Minister of Food Processing Harsimrat Kaur Badal, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Bhatinda in Punjab, she has inaugurated Rajasthan's first mega food park at which place? She has launched it at Ajmer. She is the Minister for Food Processing. The Defence Ministry has released the new draft of the Defence Production Policy. How much amount of turnover it wants to have in the military goods and services by 2025? It wants to have a turnover of 1,70,000 crore. Defence Minister is Nirmala Sitharaman. Who has been nominated by the government as India's representative to the Executive Board of UNESCO? What is his name? Executive Board. His name is Professor J.S. Rajput. UNESCO is headquartered in Paris. There are 36 World Heritage Sites in India, and UNESCO's Director General is Audrey Azoulay from France. Now, there are two countries which have withdrawn from UNESCO, US and Israel. Which IPL team? They have removed Steve Smith as their captain. So, it is Rajasthan Royals. They have removed, and also David Warner was the captain of Sunrisers Hyderabad. He has also been removed. And BCCI has also suspended both the players from IPL 2018. Now, BCCI acting president is CK Khanna and IPL chairman is Rajiv Shukla. World Theatre Day was recently observed on, it was observed on March 27, and it was started in 1961 by the International Theatre Institute. Who has been appointed as the new acting chairman of National Green Tribunal? His name is Justice Jawad Rahim. He is the former judge in the Karnataka High Court. How much amount has the Union Cabinet allocated for 3 years up to March 2020 for developing the Northeast region? And the ministry for that is called DONER, Ministry for the Development of Northeast Region, headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh. The amount that will be spent in Northeast is 4500 crore rupees. Who has been appointed? So you know that Vodafone and Idea, they have merged the companies. Who is the CEO of the merged company? His name is Mr. Balesh Sharma. What is the name of the world's largest cruise ship, which started its voyage from Barcelona? It is called Symphony of the Seas and it can accommodate 6,680 passengers. Frank Walter Steinmeier, he visited India recently. He is the president of which country? He is the president of Germany. Capital is Berlin and Angela Merkel is the chancellor of Germany. As per the Economic Affairs Secretary Subhash Chandra Garg, India right now is a $2.5 trillion economy. $2.5 trillion. It will become a $5 trillion. That is, it will double by which year? It will become $5 trillion economy by 2025. This is also the deadline for ending tuberculosis. How much amount of government guarantee has the Ministry of Finance approved in the current financial year for Indian Railway Finance Corporation IRFC bonds to be subscribed by Life Insurance Corporation or LIC? So this is 5,000 crore rupees amount. Railway Minister is Piyush Goyal and the Minister for Commerce and Industry is Suresh Prabhu. And also Railway started Project Saksham to have skill development for 1.3 million of their employees, Project Saksham, and they have started Operation Swarn for upgrading the services in their luxury train like Rajdhani and Shatabdi. Which of the following has become the first district in India to have 100% solar powered primary health center? It is Surat. It is called Diamond City. It is in Gujarat. And primary health center caters to a population of 20,000 in the hills and 30,000 in the plains. So Surat is in plains. So it has 52 primary health center. All are now powered by solar power. Which airport has received the award for the most improved airport in the APSE region in Airport Service Quality Award? It is Sardar Vallabhai Patel International Airport in Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad is the first city in India and third in Asia to be given the World Heritage City status. International Day of Remembrance of the Victims of Slavery and Transatlantic Slave Trade was recently observed when? So the theme this time was Remember Slavery, Triumphs and Struggles for Freedom and Equality. It was observed on March 25th. Asia's largest tulip garden has been opened for tourists at which place? It is in the capital of Jammu Kashmir, Srinagar. How much amount of loan is Asian Development Bank giving to Himachal Pradesh for their youth employability project? The amount is $80 million. And remember, the Minister for Skill Development is Dharmendra Pradhan. He is also the Minister for Oil and Gas. And Himachal Pradesh also launched Shakti app recently for women's safety. Jairam Thakur is the CM. Acharya Devrat is the Governor. And Himachal Pradesh has state animal called snow leopard. The construction of how many houses has been approved by the central government for urban poor under its Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana? The deadline for that is 2022. So 3.21 lakh houses is the target. Which company conducted the integrated power development system project in Varanasi to make it wireless? Varanasi will be made a wireless city by Power Grid. As per a report by India Brand Equity Foundation, India has become the dash largest electricity producer in the world. Number one is China, number two is America, and third is India. So India is third largest electricity producer. India now generates around 1160 billion unit of electricity. Which country has agreed to address India's concerns of trade deficit in a meeting held in New Delhi? India's trade deficit is $50 billion with this country. So this country is China. President Ramnath Kovind, he laid down the foundation stone of five projects of National Highway Authority of India at which place? These projects are in Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. So this was the video. I hope you liked the video, enjoyed the video. And I also missed recording videos for YouTube, but now I'll be very, very regular. And you will see lot and lot of videos in the next 1 month. Thank you so much for watching.